sippin' in a brand of time. When the two guys and hatred multiply. Multiply. I said I can't sleep. I remember wondering if I'm putting my check in. My nigga running the terminal, 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 and I'm getting money for the end of it. Never fuck around, set a flow. Speaking for the people like a delegate. When I said you went to delegate, I actually did it with the proper etiquette. Everybody wanna get ahead of it, no. Ain't taking it, it's not good. I ain't nothing but the money strong, get it to the top. I'm still getting quiet, never stop, that's a money drop. Better put my motherfucker to get it in. Bought a whole world, spent it for the dividend. But I'm in another system, everybody hates it again. And they miss them, why can't we relax it? Stop putting money on things that I know my vibe. I get literally 1,000 tweets in like a minute. Like it's like all the time. So it's hard to see. Like I just reply when I see shit. If I didn't see it, don't take it personal. I just didn't see that shit. Anyway, so Raymond goes, he goes, oh man, I see that your Orlando show is sold out. Fuck, can I buy a ticket? And I'm like, in my mind, I'm like, no, because it's sold out. So I DM him. I usually don't say shit like this. I just like to do nice shit on the side. But I was like, hey, but since he's here, so I was like, hey, don't worry, I got you. Give me your name. Did you bring anybody? Oh, nice. Who's that?
Vanessa.
How do you guys know each other? You work together? Right, work together. I'm kidding.
Goddamn!
No, I'm just kidding, Vanessa. I'm joking. Anyway, so he hits me up. And he's like, can I get the tickets? And whatever. And I was like, don't worry, I'll take care of you. So I was like, you plus one, I'll put you on the list. Yo, last night, after I get on stage, off stage, take a shower, I'm laying in bed, and I get a fucking, this DM, and he's like, hey, bro, I didn't know the show was tonight. And I was like, what? Like, in my mind, I'm like, what? And I literally talked to my wife, right? And I was like, yo, this motherfucker just had me do all this shit, and he didn't even show up to the show, and he's like, could I get some for Fort Lauderdale? Hey, and I can't hate the player, you know what I'm saying? Just hate the game. Of course, of course you're gonna ask. If you could make it, why not? But I asked my wife, I was like, yo, I fucking went out of my way, made sure this dude was straight, put him on the list, like, so he was in a good area, everything, guest list, all this other shit, and he didn't show up. I was like, should I do it? I really want to do it, but I don't want this guy to, like, walk all over me. And she was like, no.
Suck my dick.
I was like, you know, and she was like, no, he seems sweet, babe. You should definitely do it. So thank my wife and myself, because that's why you're here, and everybody makes a noise for this man. It's fucking awesome. Man, have you guys had a good time tonight? Do you want to go home yet? Listen, man, before we get into this next joint, I want to thank you all so much for coming out here. And I'm not trying to even get too deep. I just want to simply say, it's kind of fucked up to say this. I don't want to get morbid, but I want you to understand that there's people in this room tonight that will not be alive next week. There's people that won't be alive in a year. There's people that have ambitions and dreams of careers and families, and they're not going to get to experience those things. And not because they might be sick or dealing with something, but because that's just how life is. You can walk outside and get hit by a fucking bus. Now, I say all this shit to say, you must enjoy the moment that you live in. So many people live as though tomorrow is guaranteed, and I've even been there myself. But the harsh reality is that it's not. Now, depending on what you may have done in your past, fuck it, let that shit go. Live in this moment and plan for the future. I am so happy and glad to know that all of you people were happy and healthy enough to fucking walk or crawl or cut your ass into this piece of ass. And I just want to say that I thank you. I also want to thank Dane, who runs my sound, Ryan, who runs my lights, Chad, who runs my wall. I want to thank the promoters that brought me down here to Florida, the fucking beautiful venue itself, all the security guards keeping us safe. Make some noise for everyone else who makes this show great. And I just want to say, man, I've had my ups and downs, you know what I'm saying? And I'm excited. I don't know where the future is going to take me. I'm excited for that. But I appreciate this moment that I have right here on the stage tonight, because this place right here, right now, is a place that I have never been.